Welcome back to the Penn Sports Network. I'm Mike Mahoney. I'm here with the women's soccer coach here at Penn, Darren Ambrose. And Darren, you guys just back from California and probably still a little jet lagged, even though a few days out. But talk a little bit about you played two games out there. You got a 1-0 win. You took a 1-0 loss. Just talk a little bit about what happened on the field out in California.
It was a great trip for us. It's a long trip, and it's a challenge for teams to go out there and play, because the level of play in California is very, very high. But I thought we were fantastic on Friday night, and we played as well as really we could have. And we held the game, we kept possession of the game. And I was really pleased with Caitlin Campbell when she scored, because I thought she was a rock for us all game. We're dangerous on set pieces. It was nice to see Sarah get an assist as well. And then we turn around Sunday. We had a lot of fatigue, and unfortunately had a lot of girls get some mystery illness overnight on the Friday night after the game. And we had eight or nine of them were out literally all day on Saturday. So we went into the game Sunday. We had to change the way we played a little bit, and lacked a little bit of energy. And I think the trip just kind of took its toll. But to our credit, in the second half, we fought really hard, and I thought we may deserve to get a tie out of it at the end. So that was a good, it was a good showing from us overall, given the nature of the trip and some of the adversity we faced. And I thought our kids responded pretty well at the end. So, glad to get home.
Yeah.
Glad to get home, but it was a good trip overall.
You kind of touched on it just now, but certainly in your coaching career and in unique situation happening on this trip, just talk a little bit about the mystery illness, as you call it.
Yeah, I thought we were going to have to play seven-a-side on Sunday. In fact, I almost called the coach, O'Malley, who's a friend of mine, and said, can we play seven-a-side? Because we were really, really thin on the ground. And it's never happened to me. And to be in that situation, our trainer did a great job in nursing the kids back. But we were on the plane home, and some people on the flight home with us were also on the flight out there, and they overheard and were talking with us, and they also got sick. And it seemed a lot of people who were on that flight out ended up picking up some kind of illness. So, we're recovering from it little by little. I think we'll all be healthy, today or tomorrow. Okay. Again, it was just an interesting experience all around.
I'm sure. Off the field, obviously, a trip to California, not something you guys do every year. This is only the second time the program's done it.
Yeah.
Just talk a little bit about off the field, some of the things you might do when you make a trip like this to California. You go out of the region for a long weekend such as this.
Yeah, no, we tried to touch base with some alumni. We had a nice event hosted by a former alum. We had a few alumni come to our games, which was great. Girls that played for me when I first came to Penn, and it was great to see them and parents of former players who still are connected to the program, and it's just such a rewarding experience when you go out there. I had a lot of recruits come out, don't get to see us play, came out to both games, and I think we're impressed with the way we carried ourselves, which, again, it's a feather in our cap to our kids and how they carried themselves, and we represented our program and the school very well.
Good. One player in particular who's really had a good couple of weeks now, Caroline Williams, your goaltender. Yeah. Really kind of seems to have taken off. She had 7 saves in that game against Dayton 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Comes back with 6 on Friday, 5 on Sunday.
Yeah.
And really, going back to Dayton, which I saw, several of those were spectacular saves. Just talk a little bit about her play the last couple of weeks in the net.
She's living up to the billing she had when we recruited her. And I've known Caroline for quite some time. And she's maturing. I think the thing is she's being pushed. I think, our other goalkeepers and Rachel and Sarah have done a great job in competing. I think Caroline realizes, she's on her toes this year. And she's made some saves that have won games for us. And I think to do well and have a good season, you got to have that in a goalkeeper. You got to have a kid who can make a save when your team needs it. And it gives confidence to the rest of the team. And I think that's what she's done this year.
You got Harvard and Navy coming in this weekend. Harvard, the Ivy opener for you guys.
Yeah.
Now, 2 years ago, you had them in here. You guys were the defending Ivy champions. They were a middle-of-the-pack team. You beat them 2-0. It seemed like business as usual.
Yeah.
Fast forward 2 years, Harvard's gone 11-1-1 in league. Yeah. Since then, they've won the last 2 Ivy titles. They come in as the defending champs. How have things changed, and what do you expect on Friday night from them?
Harvard are always a good team. They went through a lot of coaching changes. Ray has come in, and it brought a little bit of consistency, I think, in recruiting and philosophy. They've got good players. A couple of years ago, again, we were very confident going in, and yeah, we beat them. You know, we went up there last year and we were close to pulling off a result as well when they went on to win the league. It'll be a fierce game, there's no question. I think, you know, the pressure's a little bit on them. I mean, they're defending champions, mm-hmm. for sure, and that they are a good team. But I like our group this weekend. I think we'll be up for it. I'm ready for the challenge.
And then Sunday afternoon, you'll have Navy going back out of conference, Navy out of the Patriot League. You haven't played Navy since 2000.
Sure.
What are you expecting from Navy on Sunday?
Anytime you play one of the academies, you expect discipline and you expect hardworking kids, and that's what we're going to see. You know, well-organized, never-quit kind of mentality. I mean, it's an honor to play those kids as well. I think it'll be a good experience for our team. And by no means is that, you know, a game anyone can take for granted.
Sure. All right. Thanks, Darren. Once again, the women home twice this weekend. Friday night at 7, they'll be hosting Harvard in the Ivy League opener at Rhodes Field. Sunday at noon, Navy comes to town. For the Penn Sports Network, I'm Mike Mahoney.